This is just a simple note on vectorized operations in R. So vectorized operations is one of the features of the R language that makes it easy to use on the command line and makes it very kind of nice to write code without having to do lots of looping and things like that. And so it's kind of a natural thing to have in a computational language. Many other types of languages like MATLAB have this kind of feature. So the idea with vectorized operations is that things can happen in parallel when you, for example, want to do a computation. For example, suppose I got two vectors here, x and y. X is the sequence 1 through 4, and y is the sequence 6 through 9. And I want to add the two vectors together. Now, when I say I want to add them, what I mean is I want to add the first element of x to the first element of y, the second element of x to the second element of y, etc., the third element to the third element. So I want to kind of do things in parallel like that. So in other languages, you might have to write a loop to do that. So you loop through each element and kind of add them one by one. But in R, you can just use the plus to, on the two vectors, and it will just add them together. So x plus y kind of does what you would expect. It adds 1 to 6, 2 to 7, 3 to 8, and 4 to 9. So you get the vector 7, 9, 11, 13. Similarly, you can use the greater than or less than symbols to give you logical vectors. So for example, x greater than 2, x is actually a vector of four numbers. So which number are you comparing to 2? Well, the vectorized operation compares all the numbers to 2, and it gives you a vector of falses and trues depending on which numbers happen to be bigger than 2. So you can also use greater than equal to, and that'll tell you which numbers are greater than and equal to 2. And the double equal sign tests for equality. So it'll take each element of y and test to see whether it's equal to 8. The other arithmetic operations like multiplication by the asterisk and division by the solidus are all vectorized types of operations. So when you want to multiply, divide, add, subtract vectors, you can do the natural thing, just add them together or multiply them together, and the operation will be done in parallel. Similarly, you can add and subtract and multiply and divide matrices together. So it's useful to know this because there are different types of matrix multiplication. So I've created two matrices here, x and y. X is the matrix 1 through 4. It's a 2 by 2 matrix. And y is a matrix that's all tens. It's also a 2 by 2 matrix. So if I just do x times y, this is not a matrix multiplication. This is an element-wise multiplication. So the first, the kind of the 1-1 element of x is multiplying the 1-1 element of y, and the 2-2 element is multiplying the 2-2 element of the other matrix, etc. So each element is multiplied together in parallel. Same when you do division. This is not a matrix inverse or something like that. This is just dividing one matrix literally element by element by another. So if you want to do a true matrix multiplication, you have to use the %%, which that's the symbol for a matrix multiplication. That's it for vectorized operations for now. You'll see these a lot more often later on, but I just wanted to introduce this idea because it makes code easier to write, and for those of you who are kind of used to other types of programming languages, if you've programmed in other languages where you can't do this kind of thing, it's sometimes it's common to kind of reflexively go to something like a for loop or a while loop or whatever it is. But in a language like R, you can just use the vectorized operations to make the code a lot simpler.